missing. I can't find him anywhere. He's not in his room. Oh, my God. What if he's run away?
Oh, honey, it's okay.
It's not okay. Our son is missing.
No, he's not. Look, he's not, all right? I told him he could go to the Buenos Dias and meet Destiny.
You did what?
He wanted to see his friend, so what's the harm in that?
Oh, for God's sake, Bo. The last thing Matthew should be doing
The last thing he needs is for us to lock him up in here.
Okay, you're right. You're right. I certainly can't blame him for wanting to pretend that everything's still normal.
Exactly. Especially when
it's anything but normal.
My son killed someone. Now we have to figure out what we're going to do about it. Well, everything's okay for the moment.
Oh, how can you even say that?
Not for the moment. At least we have some alone time now, and we can think about what we got to do.
You have any suggestions?
We can't just sit on it. I'm the commissioner of police. You're the district attorney.
I know that. I know. And it got me thinking. When Matthew shot Eddie, Matthew was distraught. I mean, he was upset before he even got to the motel.
Well, that's because he thought that I was cheating on you with the Knicks.
Right, right. And then he runs into Eddie, and Eddie taunts him and tells him all about the filthy things that he's done to me. I mean, my God, it had to confuse and terrify Matthew even more. I mean, this is just a child who's thinking that the life that he's always known is over. You know, he's not a cold-blooded killer. The shooting was impulsive. It wasn't premeditated. Matthew's not a danger to anyone.
No, but...
But Clint is. Clint is. If Clint hadn't manipulated Matthew and got him all riled up, Matthew never would have pulled that trigger. Matthew never, ever would have shot Eddie. Everything that happened that night was Clint's fault, not Matthew's.
Honey, look. We can blame Clint for what Matthew did all we want. But the truth is... It was Matthew that fired the gun. Now, we can't change that.
Well, we can't give up.
No, no. We hire a hotshot lawyer to help you build a strong defense.
A hotshot lawyer?
Yeah. You know, like Taylor.
Oh.
No, well, somebody even better than that. And you use everything that you just said about extenuating circumstances.
You think that'll work?
If Matthew throws himself on the mercy of the court... Ask for leniency? Red, he's a first-time offender. You know, he's a minor.
It's so not that simple, Bo. It's just not that simple. I mean, first of all, we could end up with a judge who would like to make an example out of Matthew just because he is our son. You know, and even if we got leniency, even if we could get him charged as a juvenile, which, by the way, is not exactly a slam dunk, given that he covered up the crime. And even if we could establish extenuating circumstances, he does what you suggest... Matthew goes to prison for life. Even if Matthew turned himself in and entered a plea, I mean, even if Taya or some other brilliant, mythical, hotshot lawyer and I could figure out how to possibly cut the deal of the century for Matthew, I can see no way for Matthew to avoid prison time. And he's just a baby. He's just a baby. Can he possibly survive that?
Honey, we don't have a choice. We can't just keep quiet about this forever. Right? And even if we tried, how would we live with that?
How would we live with ourselves if we sent our son to prison?
Oh, we're both in shock right now. Over what Matthew's done. I know it hurts, but we can't pretend that this didn't happen.
I can't help you. Because that's all I got.
No. It isn't. Listen to me. I want you to imagine that Matthew's not your son. He's your client. Okay? You're defending him. And you know what you would do. You would work on a plea, and then you would do everything you could to minimize the jail time.
But he's not some client, though. He's my baby.
No, honey, he's not a baby anymore.
He's still our son.
Yeah, but okay, what about what this is going to do to him? What kind of a man do you think he's going to grow into? Knowing that he killed someone and he got away with it?
This isn't getting away with it.
And what about the Ford boys?
Oh, my God. Eddie Ford terrorized those kids.
I know that. Eddie Ford was nothing but pure evil, but he was their father. And I think they deserve a resolution. And what do you think this is going to do to us? Knowing that we covered up a murder that goes against everything that we stand for, everything that we believe in.
Well, then I have to ask you, when it comes to crunch time, when that moment comes, can you actually see turning in your old son?
It's Mayor Dorian Lord here. We need to talk about Eddie Ford's killer. You're both here.
Now's not a good time, Dorian.
Oh, I am sure it is not. Speculation is running rampant in this town as to why the two of you dropped charges against Clint, fueled, of course, in large part by that biatch Phyllis Rose.
Is it?
Yes. Popular opinion is that the two of you decided to get those wagons in a circle around Clint. Is that what happened? Oh, did you talk Nora into dropping charges against Clint after what he did to my husband, your son?
Dorian, believe me, the last thing that we tried to do was protect Clint.
You have video of Clint leaving the murder scene carrying a weapon, and yet for no reason you released him with no explanation.
We had our reasons for letting Clint go. I think that you deserve to know what they are. We followed up on that video of Clint with the gun, and it was misleading.
Misleading? How can it be misleading? You have video of him leaving the crime scene, carrying the murder weapon. How's that misleading?
All that proves is that he was there. It doesn't prove that he's the one that pulled the trigger. It doesn't prove that the gun that he had in the video was, in fact, the murder weapon. Circumstantial.
Nora, you can't build a case against Clint.
The judge told us not to come back unless we had an airtight case. This one had holes.
So Phyllis Rose can say all she wants about me protecting Clint. It's just not true. End of story.
We dropped the charges against Clint because there was no case.
I see. And if Clint didn't do it, then who did? I expect the two of you to find that out. Thank you. Or else, it's going to be your jobs.
Okay. Dorian, I think we talked about this. You can't fire me. I'm an elected official. Minute there, I really thought you were going to tell her about Matthew.
No, I'm not going to say anything until we figure out what we're going to do. Right now, I'm going to see Clint.
Bo, do you think that's a good idea?
Dorian is on the war path. You know she's going to go right to him and try to squeeze him for information about why we let him go. And I don't want him to say anything about Matthew.
Okay, just hurry back, will you? Please.
This out.
How? And every option is a nightmare.
I want you to find out who roughed up Shane Marasco at Landview High School. He's my grandson, that's who. and you make damn sure it never happens again. Oh, to what do I owe the pleasure?
Dorian's sniffing around about Eddie Ford's murder. I need to know that you're going to keep your mouth shut about Matthew, since you're the only one who knows that he did it.
Mom, hurry up. Turn the TV on now.
Where is it?
I think Phyllis Rose is about to out me as murderer.
Here it is, ducklings. The bombshell I've been promising.